In the last video, I finished making the doors for my kitchen cabinets. And in this one, I'm going to spray on the clear finish and install them in the kitchen. Since I don't have a spray booth or anywhere inside to paint these doors, I needed to make sure that I had a clear day to do this because it will take most of a full day to spray on all three coats. The product that I'm using is clear water-based polyurethane. And this is satin finish, by the way. I'm not a big fan of really glossy looking kitchen cabinets. I've got my extension ladder set up as a drying rack, and believe me, it doesn't take long. It almost dries in the time it takes for me to carry it over. The gun has a 2mm tip, and I'm spraying the poly full strength, as in I didn't thin it down. Anyway, the first coat goes on both the front and the back. And then after the first coat is dried enough, I can sand it with 220 grit paper. And I'm doing that by hand. And even though it's not really critical for this, I'm trying to follow the grain direction as much as possible. And to sand into the corners of the panel, I made a block that has sandpaper on the face and on the side. So it sands right into the corner. And then I can finish up the field by hand. After the sanding, it's very important to clean up the dust that it leaves behind. Some people use a tack cloth, but I prefer to use a clean, damp rag to thoroughly wipe it off, and then I'll dry it with another clean towel. And then the second and third coats get sprayed on exactly the same way. And of course, I'm sanding in between those coats as well, but this time I'm using 400 grit paper instead. After I had the third coat sprayed on and the doors laid out to dry, I had the problem that can happen when you're spraying stuff outdoors. A fly got stuck in the fresh finish. And I know this kind of looks cruel, but I really have to get this thing off of here. So I figured the best way was to use a razor blade and cut it off. I know, start typing your hateful comments. Bug murderer. I'm a bug murderer, I admit it. But anyway, I used the razor blade as a scraper to scrape out as much of the wings as I could, because those are the things that really stuck. And what I couldn't scrape away, I got with the sandpaper. And then, of course, I had to respray that corner. And the trick here is not to put too much on, but you need to get it on there thick enough so that it actually works. And when it dried, it blended right in, and you couldn't even see where the problem was before. So I gave the finish overnight to dry to make sure that it was hardened up enough to withstand handling. And then I set up my drill press to drill out for the hinges. And what I did was I did one door at a time and I brought it in and hung it. And I actually filmed that, but for some reason I seem to have lost that footage. So you can use your imagination. There's not a whole lot to this anyway. These hinges are very easy to use. You just need to locate them correctly and then screw them onto the cabinets. However, after I had all of the doors hung, I discovered a problem that I really should have avoided in the first place. The two doors above the range hood are slightly too big and they overlap. So there are a couple of different ways to handle this. Of course, I could resize the doors, but that would mean that I would have to redo the finish on both doors as well. So I decided to take another approach, and that's to mortise the hinges into the face frame on the cabinet, and that'll give me the clearance. And I would only have to do that on one side. Now, obviously, it would have been better if I had made sure that the doors fit before I finished them, and that was really a rookie mistake on my part. Normally what I do is, after I finish building the doors, and even before I sand them, I will hang the door and make sure that it fits and adjust as needed, and then I'll sand it and finish it, and that way for sure I won't have any problems. But of course I didn't do that here, and now I'm making up for it. Anyway, this is an acceptable fix, and it's something that you have to be looking for in order to see it after the door goes on. And it's a good example of how to deal with problems as they arise. Craftsmanship is not just the quality of the work and how few mistakes the worker makes. It's also how he deals with the mistakes when they happen. Anyway, that's going to wrap this one up here. I've got one other thing that I need to do with these doors, and that's to install the handles that I picked out for them. And I'll be covering that in an upcoming video.